I am Dr. Chandrika Shekhar, working as an obstetrician and gynecologist at Chirag Hospital and Maternity Center, JP Nagar, second phase. I am also going as a consultant to visit Malti Manipal Hospital, Jayanagar, Bangalore, and Apollo Cradle Hospital, Jayanagar, 5th block, and also Motherhood Hospital in Banashankari, second stage. While coming to Kegels exercise, it is a very, very important exercise that is needed in a female's life, because female goes through so many things in her life. Means most important thing is pregnancy. When the pregnancy and all happens, what happens is there is a something called as pelvic floor. There is a pelvic bone like this, and the down part is a pelvic floor. That pelvic floor is involves some muscles, and that is the outlet for the reproductive tract as well as the urinary tract. And because of the changes that the lady undergoes in her life, there is strain on this pelvic floor and it becomes very lax. Because of the laxity of the pelvic floor, she may have problems with her urinary control. Means so many people will have the inability to control the urination. Means that is one is called as urge incontinence. Because the moment they feel like passing urine, they are not able to hold it. They have to pass it. So that is a disability of the pelvic floor. And so many times because the patient becomes obese, obesity also is one of the causes for the laxity of the pelvic floor. And one more thing is the routine thing that a patient, that a woman passes through, that is the reproduction. In reproduction, there is a outlet, that is a perennial outlet, wherein the baby comes out. And because of the big size of the baby that comes out through the natural passage of the birth canal, there is laxity of the pelvic floor. All these things cause laxity, and because of that laxity, there are so many problems for the patient. One most important problem is ability to control the defecation and urination. Because of the laxity, so many times they are not able to control the urine as they were doing in their younger days. That is one thing. And second thing is sexually active women will also have too much of laxity of the vagina. So because of these problems, we have to advise something for the patient to get over this laxity of the pelvic floor. That advice is the Kegels exercise. Kegels exercise is one which has the ability to get over this perennial laxity. So that exercise is what we do is the pelvic floor muscles. We tell them to exercise that. That is to contract and retract the pelvic floor. There is a way of teaching that pelvic floor exercises which can be demonstrated better with the patient and the doctor with each other. So most easily what I can tell is when the women sit on the hard surface like this, she has to contract the perineal muscle in such a way that she sucks the floor on which she is sitting. That is the way she has to do. So that time she will be pulling the thing on which she is sitting towards the abdomen. So that time it will strengthen the perineal muscles. That is one way. And one more way is by trying to control urination in between. Means when you are passing urine, in between you have to control in the middle, maybe 2 to 3 times. Those times it will make the pelvic floor muscles to act and it will strengthen the pelvic floor. It is like a physiotherapy for the perineal floor. And as I am a doctor who also practices alternative medicine, I also practice what is called as pranic healing. So in pranic healing, we have the concept there are so many chakras in the body. So one vital chakra that our body has is the basal chakra or Mooladhara chakra. So what we do in pranic healing is we try to activate that Mooladhara chakra. It has got the same effect of this Kegels exercise. So one more thing is what we do in alternative medicine is we do pranayamas. Pranayamas we do very frequently. We ask the people to do pranayama every day. So when you do pranayama, we do what is called as kapalabhati. In kapalabhati, there is only some breathing exercise in which we try to tell them to incorporate what is called as Ashwini Mudra. Ashwini Mudra is a very vital thing that you have to do along with kapalabhati. So many people do not know this. And what I have seen through experience is that Mooladhara Chakra gets activated by this Ashwini Mudra. So what is the technique of doing Ashwini Mudra is what is called as anal sphincter, the anal outlet in the human body. In every kapalabhati breath, each breath we have to contract that muscles around the anal outlet. So that is called as Ashwini Mudra. By doing that Ashwini Mudra very effectively, almost every day, definitely you can get over what is called as urge incontinence. That is the inability to control the urine. That you will get over by doing this Ashwini Mudra in kapalabhati. So this is a very, very important thing that I have experienced. And I think every lady should incorporate this in her life to get over that problems. So that is all what is about Kegels exercise.